Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be walking through a linear spline interpolation example. If you missed our previous video on the theory of linear spline interpolation, I will leave a link in the description down below for you. Let's get right into our questions. The first question here states that we first need to find our necessary interpolating functions, and then we are given a few inputs that we must find the outputs for. Let's first begin by plotting our points of interest around the areas in which we need to interpolate. In this example, we do not need to plot the 20 data point, as we already have one data point to the right of our largest point that we will be interpolating for. That is our 12 data point. So, we can see by this graph here that we need two interpolating polynomial functions, and our data point at 7 is actually unnecessary. So, as we talked about in the theory video, this is one of the major differences between spline interpolation and the global interpolation methods that we talked about. Spline interpolation does not need to use all the data points supplied to us, whereas methods like the divided difference and Lagrange polynomials do. Now, we can begin solving for our first and second interpolating polynomials for this question. Just briefly, since we are going to be finding straight lines or first order polynomials as p1 and p2, let's just write out the equation for a straight line and a general first order polynomial, and you can see that they are actually the same thing. We are now ready to begin solving for our two polynomials. To do so, we just need to apply the correct data points as our parameters for the general equation of a straight line and simplify. This results in P1 being 1.2x plus 0.8, with a domain of this function being the following. Secondly, we will now solve P2 in the exact same way, using our data points at x equals 9 and 12. After applying our known values and simplifying, we are left with 4x over 3 minus 2 with a domain of 9 to 12. Now, we have our interpolating functions. We just need to apply our desired inputs. Firstly, we have x equals 2, and since that is in our domain of p1, that is the function that we will use. And you can see that this results in an output of 3.2. Secondly, we have x equals 5, which again falls in the domain of p1. Therefore, for an input of 5, we get an output of 6.8. Lastly, we have x equals 10, and this falls in the domain of our second interpolating polynomial function, p2. Applying an input of 10, we get an output of 11.33. And there we go, we just answered all the questions that we were asked. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how we go about solving problems using linear spline interpolation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.